Hello students, so we have the question in place. The problem is we have two circles. There is a direct common tangent AB. AB is direct common tangent. Direct common tangent means this is a tangent which is common to both the circles, and as it is given that it is a direct common tangent. So there are two types of tangents, common tangents. One is direct common tangent and second is transverse common tangent. So this one is given as direct common tangent, okay? And we need to find out when we join A to C and B to C. C is the common point at which these two circles intersect each other. So we need to find out the angle C, or we call angle ACB or BCA, okay? We need to find out this angle. So how do we solve such a question? Is let us try to solve. The property that we'll be using is, let us see that tangent is always perpendicular to radius given. This is the property that we use, okay? That means that this is a tangent, this is a tangent to this circle, and this is a tangent to this circle. So if we draw radius, if I find out the center O, and if I find out the center O dash, and if I connect this center with this point, and I connect this A point to O, so I get OA is the radius, and here O dash B is the radius. So this AB is perpendicular to OA, and this AB is again perpendicular to OB. Okay, so this is a property that we'll be using in this question. Okay, so perpendicular means they will make an angle of 90 degree with each other. So this angle I'm talking about, this is complete angle, that is 90, and this complete angle will be again 90 degrees. So what I have two right angles here, and OA and O dash B are the radius of the two circles, and AB is the direct common tangent, DCT, D, C and T, okay? And I need to find out what is the value of this angle, okay? So by using this property, and second property that we will be using is that sum of angles of a triangle is always equal to 180 degree. That is, if we have a triangle, all the angles in a triangle will sum up to 180 degree. So this will be using, okay? So to find out this angle, what we do is, we suppose that this angle is x and this angle is y, okay? So I have this angle x, this angle y. If this is x, total is 90. So this leftover portion, this complete is 90. So this leftover portion is 90 minus x, and this again leftover portion is 90 minus y. So I get two angles from this. This is 90 minus x, this is 90 minus y. What do we do is, we draw OC and we draw O dash C, okay? So as you can see that this is the radius R1, and this is again the radius R1. So we use the property, third property, that the equal sides have equal opposite angles. What does this property means? Equal sides, if the sides are equal, okay, equal sides have equal opposite angles. That means if these two sides are equal, the angle opposite to these sides, that is angle opposite to this is this angle, and angle opposite to this side is this angle. So these two angles will be equal. So this is 90 minus x, this also is 90 minus x, okay? So if this is 90 minus x, this we calculate 90 minus x. Again, if we consider this triangle, this is R2, this is again R2. So by using this property again, this is, there are two radius, R2 and R2. the two sides. These sides both are equal, that means their angles opposite to these will also be equal. That means if this is 90 minus y, the side of the angle opposite to this side is again 90 minus y. Okay, so from this property I get to know that this is 90 minus x and this is 90 minus y. All right, so now what we do is we try to calculate this angle. Now first we will calculate this angle. What is this angle and what is this angle equal to? Okay, now we apply in triangle OC and A, we try this, we use this property 180 degree. Okay, this is not known, so this is question mark. Plus 90 minus x, 90 minus x becomes 180 minus x, 180 minus 2x. This total is equal to 180 degree. So question mark will be equal to 2x. This question mark that we are talking about is 2x. Okay. And if we see this triangle, triangle O dash CB, this is question mark. Plus 90 minus y, 90 minus y becomes 180 minus 2y. This is again equal to 180 degree. So question mark will be equal to 2y. So we get from here that this is 2y. This is 2x and this is 2y. Okay, students. So we are done with this much now. All right. Now we needed to find out, we have found all the angles, but we are not still yet found out this angle that we were asked to find out. Okay, so for this angle what we do is, what is this angle? If we apply question mark plus x plus y is equal to 180 degree, so question mark that we want to find out is equal to 180 minus x, or we say 180 minus 180 degree minus complete x plus y. Okay, so if we get the value of x and y, we'll be able to find out this angle. Okay, so how to calculate the value of x and y? Let us see that there is a quadrilateral A B O dash and O. A B O dash and O. This is a quadrilateral. Okay, in which this and this angle is 90 90. So angles of a quadrilateral is equal to always 360 degree. So this is 90 plus 90 plus 2y plus 2x, this is equal to 360 degrees. This all the angles will be equal to 360 degree. This 90 plus 90 is 180. 2y plus 2x is equal to 360 minus 180 is 180, and x plus y comes out to be 90 degrees from here. So putting the value of x plus y here, we get 180 minus 90, that is equal to 90 degrees. So we needed to find out this question mark, so question mark comes out to be 90 degrees here. Okay, so whenever there is a direct common tangent, if we draw this direct common tangent and if we connect this with the common point C, so this always will be equal to 90 degrees. So this is the right answer, students. Okay. So we have the solution for this question. So good question, but we needed to solve this with the help of three properties that we are using, this first, second and third. Okay. So we have another question from geometry, that is circles. So we have a circle and there is an outer point, external point. So from this external point I draw two tangents. This one is tangent 1 and the second is tangent 2. Okay, so there are two tangents. These two tangents are connected, this common point A and B are connected to the center O, and it is given that they make an angle of 50 degree on the circumference. Okay, so I need to find out this angle, question mark. Need to find out this. Okay, so this is the question. So how to proceed with the question? First, we start from here. That is given is this 50 degrees. Okay. So we use the same property that angle made at the center. Angle at the center is twice of angle at circumference. But this will be the arc should be same. Arc is same. That is this arc, AB arc. AB arc make an angle of 50 degree on the circumference. So on the center, on the same side, so this will be double. 50, double of 50 is 100 degrees. So this is 100. Okay. So now the question becomes very easy because we have second property as the tangent is always perpendicular to the radius. So this is tangent, this is the radius, they will be perpendicular. That means they will have a 90 degree angle. Here also they will be have a 90 degree angle. So this completes the quadrilateral. So now we have a quadrilateral. Quadrilateral is OA, this point we consider C, OACB. OACB, this is a quadrilateral that we use. Okay, the sum of angles should be equal to 360 degree. So we have three angles given, 90 plus 100 plus 90, and last we need to find out this angle. So this is also, this is equal to 360 degrees. So question mark will be equal to, this is 280, so 360 minus 280, that comes out to be 80 degrees. So this is directly equal to 80 degree. Okay students, so you can remember this by heart, that this and this always is equal to 180. If this is equal to 180, so leftover is always equal to 180. This plus this is always equal to 180. If this is 100, 180 minus 100 will give you 80 degrees. Okay. If this is something else, so we need to just subtract this angle from 180 degree and we can find out this angle. If this is given, this can be find out by subtracting this angle from 180. This is given, this can be find out by subtracting this angle from 180 degrees. Okay. So this is an easy question, that is, and we find out the angle as 80 degrees is the right answer. Okay students, thank you.